Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're gonna look into how to model this three stone ring and what you need to pay attention on the structure. Are you ready? Let's get started. To start this ring, you need to have the exactly stone size that you are going to set into the ring and position the angle that you like first. If you like to know how to build a stone, I have a video here that can show you step-by-step process. You can check out the video. I will have a link in the description below. First of all, I would like to set it up my ring size. In this case, I'm going to set it a diameter for 16 millimeter. We are going to pipe our prong later on, but I want to have a guideline here. In my case, I'm going to have a prong size is 1.2 millimeter in diameter, so I'm going to offset my circle for 0.6 millimeter. So that way, when I'm drawing any of the line, I want to make sure it's not passing with this circle there. Okay, so that's starting with the arc. I'm going to have this somewhere over here. We can have the prong a little bit longer, so that will be good for a stone setting. And I want to make sure my near is on my all snap, so that will snap over there. So that will be my first line. If I'm looking at my right view, I wanted to have a line go from roughly the same height, and then it's coming over and coming to the center, roughly something like this. And then this might snapping somewhere that you don't want it. And we can do project to C plane. And we want to delete the input equal yes. So this one will be flat. And let's take a look on what we have. The line that we are going to create, we are going to use the commands called curve from to view. And we're going to have this curve and this curve. So you're automatically creating this curve over there. So let's do a test. Let's piping this curve and see what happens. We're going to use the pipe. And then the radius is 0.6 over here and 0.6 on the other end. Notice that it's just right at where my ring size is. It's not past that ring size. That is what that reference line for. Okay, so this is the first that I have. You want to check if it is too close to the stone like the one that I have on the left, but not touching the stone like the one I have on the right. Okay, so if that is the case, instead of do it like again and changing all the time, what we can do is we can rebuild this guy to be last control point. All right. And then we want to pipe it one more time. This time we want to record the history and we pipe it over there. So if that is too close, now we can turn on our select our curve and we can turn on the control point and we can move it around so it is not too close to the stone. So that way allow you to do some editing. And for example, if this is not close enough, we can have it move it in. I always like to have my prong at exactly where that 45 degree angle, it will look much nicer. So you can tweak it into the way that you like. I might need to have this point going down because it's touching the stone. It doesn't look too good on the side view. So you will spend some time to tweak it until you find the best curve for the stone there. Then let's do a test to mirror on the other side and see how it goes. So the first one will look something like this, and I'm going to temporarily to hide those two. The second one that we are going to do, it's gonna go from here, and again we want to go a little bit higher, and we're gonna come over here and make it into something like this and blend it to the inside of a ring shank. And again, you can adjust to whatever that looks good to you. All right, so after that, we are going to looking at our right view again. On my right view, I'm going to draw another curve. This curve is going to go from there and end it somewhere here. So this will be the curve that I'm going to use for the smaller stone. Let's use the curve from two view. We're gonna have this curve and this curve. So now we are getting this curve right here. Okay, in order for it to blend really well, I'm actually need to have somewhere blend from this point to this point. So we're gonna use the split command. We want to split with the point somewhere about here, and this one somewhere with the point somewhere about here. So let's did it this one and did it the button. So now we have that opening over there. We can use the blend tool to blend the curve from here to here. All right, so that looks all right to me. I'm going to select all of them, join them, and also rebuild into 10 point. All right, let's do a test with the pipe, the same diameter that I'm going to have, and see if that go well. Now let's turn on what we had before and see if that is a good match there. All right, it looks nice over there. Then I'm going to have this one and mirror to the other side. All right, so let's double check and see if everything is all right. And again, this might be too long. You might want it to be shorter, longer, whatsoever. I'm not gonna spend time on tweaking it. For the demonstration purpose here, I would like to show you what to do next. So we are going to go mirror to the other side, and then we will have the setting part is almost done. Okay, now the second part that I need to do is about the ring shank. We're going to have this shank. We're going to have a shank. It's going to start it somewhere a little bit inside of my prong, and it's coming over here and coming over here. Okay, so again, if that doesn't look too good to you, you can always adjust it. All right, so that is that, and I'm going to creating an area that we can set the stone later. So let's go ahead to creating the profile. For the profile, I always like to use the conic corner, and because it will give me a very nice cushion looking, because it will give me really nice cushion looking shape there. And let me move this one from the midpoint to the quadrant of our inside of a ring shank. And then you can adjust the thickness if you like to. I may also want to make it a little bit thicker there. Okay, so now I have a cross section over there. I'm going to mirror to the other side, and let's use the sweep one. This is our rail. This is gonna be cross section and cross section. I always like to have my seam inside of a ring shank. All right, so then we have the bottom ring shank. If you want to have a bottom a little bit thinner, you can create another profile there on the bottom. Now let's take a look right here, right at the front view. We have this over there. I'm gonna make a copy. I want to rotate it into the angle of, it's 90 degrees with the rail that it's going to. And then we're gonna take a look on this view. I want to make sure it's touching the prong. I also want to make sure it's a little bit thinner. All right, so that's starting with the sweep one rail, and make sure you turn on the history. This is the rail, this is the cross section. And we always want to make sure the seam is inside of a ring shank. Okay, so let's take a look on this one. If that doesn't look good to you, we're going to pick up the curve, and then we can move those points in and out, up and down, to get the best curve to fitting into the design. All right, so you can go ahead and tweak it until you like it. So once you like everything, let's go ahead to cap it. And of course, we want to have a rounded edges, so we will go ahead to fit the edges, say 0.3 millimeter. If you like it, just go ahead to mirror to the other side. If that inside doesn't look nice to you, you can go ahead to using a sweep instead of piping. All right, so there's a lot of things that you can tweak over there. Now let's talk about the structure. I'm going to turn the stone off, and let's take a look on that. All right, so those are nice. They are touching, so that will be fine on the casting. Those two is touching with this red one, so they are fine with the structure. However, I might facing the issue is if something is hitting on this direction, it might crash to the other prong. So we do actually need some structure in the middle to hold it. Okay, so this is what I will do. I will go to the top view and I'm going to use the arc starting with here, roughly here, and then we want to get an arc there. All right, so this is the curve that we have there. Let's bring up to where the location should be. And where is that location should be? It should be under the girdle area, and we can move in a little bit. All right, let me turn the stone off one more time. So now we have this one here. We can go ahead to pipe it again. The pipe we're going to use like 0.4 millimeter there. So this way is giving you the structure that is going to hold on this side, so you won't get crashed, or the stone will hold it better. So we will just need to mirror to the other side, and we'll do the same on those two. All right, so the proportion may not look 100% correct yet. It's because I want to show you something really quick, but you get the idea, and feel free to let me know how you're doing. If you want to know more about a stone setting, don't forget to check out my course on my website for the stone setting. So when it finish, it should have a nice proportion and the right prong size and something similar like this. I hope you enjoy. Please like and share and comment on my video. That helped me to reach more people that want to learn Rhino. Thank you, and I'll see you next.